Hello, and welcome to this Archer Point presentation on using deferrals in Business Central. My name is Alex Wiley, and I'll be leading you through this demonstration today. The first thing I'm going to do is go up and search for my deferral templates. This is where I can define multiple deferrals and set them up for both expenses and revenue. This can be done by going and setting up a new code. So I'm going to jump into one that I've already created. I've given it a description, and I've also assigned it to a deferral account. So when you get started, if you don't already have a deferral account, you want to make sure that that is set up for the revenue or expense account, and it should also be different than the related revenue or expense account that you ultimately want that revenue or expense to end up. So in this case, I have my deferred revenue account here. And if I go and look into my GL account list, I have subscription revenue. So in the example that I'm going to use today, we're going to set this up so that it puts the deferred revenue into the deferred revenue account and ultimately ends up in the subscription revenue account every month for 12 months. So once I've assigned my deferral account here, I define my deferral percentage. So would you like to recognize any revenue or expense up front, or if you'd like to do all of it? We have the calculation methods, straight line, equal per period, days per period, and our start date. When would we like that to default to? The number of periods and the period description. You'll see here that I have the percentage sign for 4 and 6. This is a way of automatically generating a description that's relevant to the deferral using the month and year. And we're going to put a link in the description of this video to refer to these codes so that you know what they are. So when you're setting them up, you can use these to create a flexible automatic reference for your descriptions. So now that my template's set up, I'm going to go to my chart of accounts, find my subscription revenue account again that we just looked at, and we can now go and see that it's been assigned this default deferral template. Now I'm going to jump into my sales orders. Going to create a new sales order for subscription revenue. And we'll do something easy like 1200. Now that this has been assigned, I can go look at how this is going to defer that by going to line, related information, and deferral schedule. Now using that template, it's giving me a suggestion of what my start date is going to be, number of periods, method, and so on. And then I can see every month it's automatically going to assign $100. I can go ahead and make changes to that here if I would like. And when you make changes, if you want to change the periods or the starting date, then you can calculate the schedule and that will change the lines that you see. When I'm happy with how that looks, I can post it. And then we'll go back and look at the general ledger entries that resulted from that. So now I can look at my subscription revenue. And here we see that it automatically put in that description using that percentage sign for percentage sign 6, showing the month and the year that it came through. And then by posting dates month by month, it's gone ahead and moved that automatically from my deferred account into my subscription revenue account. That's how you set up and use deferral codes in Business Central. If you have any other questions about how to use this, please leave a comment or reach out to Archer Point directly. Thank you.
Thank you for watching this Archer Point video. Stay in the know with the latest on Microsoft Dynamics by subscribing to our channel. You can also learn more from our blog at archerpoint.com or email info@archerpoint.com to contact us. See you in the next video.